She's music's next big thing. A girl who's just one of the boys. Your typical teen.
What did your parents think of your look? Oh.
Except this teen has been nominated for 5 Grammys. And just headlined on Saturday Night Live.
It didn't even really hit me. Just like 3 days ago.
Now, Avril Lavigne sits down for her first primetime interview. A Jane Pauley exclusive. Next on Dateline, her smash CD is called Let Go, and tonight she does. Avril Lavigne's first primetime interview, a Jane Pauley exclusive. From our studios in New York, here again is Jane Pauley.
Prepare to reset your watches because times are changing again. The strutting teenage advance of record and video have some competition. The word of the moment is simple. Less is more. The new girl in town just turned 18, and not only comes fully dressed, she packs a skateboard, a simple melody even grown-ups can relate to, and a simple message that speaks to kids, lots of them. And she's a tomboy, a really pretty one. If you've never heard the name Avril Lavigne before now, get ready to hear it a lot. She's on 3 magazine covers this month alone, one of People Magazine's 25 most intriguing people of the year. And with 5 Grammy nominations, the 5'1" small town girl from Canada is the next big thing.
It didn't even really hit me until last week when I actually sat down, literally. I was like, whoa. I mean, I feel like I've just been going nonstop, and finally just went, I'm still playing records. I'm getting more famous every day.
The first album only came out in June and is already platinum 5 times over and still climbing. Complicated was the video that launched a 17-year-old star.
You can relate to what she's saying about on her lips. And she likes everything, and she's independent. Sometimes she dresses really cool. A lot of people try to follow the way she dresses. It's like a big role model. I kind of wanted to be different and stand out, and I never really wanted to be, a normal person and have a normal lifestyle, and I've always been a crazy kid and weird, and, go to school with, twist ties in my hair or little candy wrappers in my hair, just be weird, so always dress different.
Avril Lavigne didn't always dress different. Growing up in a devout Christian family in a small town in Ontario, Canada.
What did your parents think of your look? Oh my God, that was always a problem. Whenever I'd go to sing, my mom would be like, okay, you need to do your hair nice. I need to wear a dress. I'm like, no, I don't want to wear a dress. I'm still mad at her to this day for making her wear a dress.
Parents supported her singing and helped her line up karaoke-style gigs like this when she was 14.
I've known all my life this is what I was supposed to do. Thinking all the time, what it would be like to have so many people around, visualizing what it would be like to be famous with my music, and I was dreaming, always daydreaming. My daddy bought me a microphone, and I'd be singing soundtracks, and And I just spent so much time thinking about it and so much time singing and wanting.
Meanwhile, her father was pushing to make her fantasy a reality. He got a drum kit, a keyboard, and several guitars and turned her basement into a music room.
And that's where I spent all of my time after school. You know, I remember my dad saying to me, "You need to be done there for 5 hours." Something like, "Mom, that's too much."
How were you with school?
School? I was really bad in school. I didn't have any motivation. I sit in class and doodle, curve like little things, little designs in my desk, talk, laugh, be loud, get kicked out of class. And then when I did get kicked out of class, I was like, yes!
At 16, she wasn't in school anymore. She'd been noticed. And while working with professional songwriters in New York, one evening a man came by to hear her sing. Did you know who he was?
No.
It was L.A. Reid, the president of Arista Records. But he didn't know who she was either. They were both in for a surprise.
I got a call asking me to come to the studio and hear this girl sing. I was in a rotten mood. I was in a really, really bad space. And really wasn't in the mood to do it at all. But I said, okay, you know what? Don't cancel. Just go and do it. Get it over with.
I basically sat down on a stool and sang 3 songs for him.
And within 30 seconds, my whole mood had changed. I went from being a really aggravated, irritable guy to all of a sudden feeling like, my God, I have never heard a voice like this.
I find it hard to believe.
It was very special. It was very, very special for me.
He offered her a 2-album deal on the spot.
I remember after he left, everyone was like, "He loved you, he loved you." And everyone was like, picking me up. I was like this little kid. Everyone was picking me up and swinging me around and being like, "Yeah." And I was just like, cool. And they're like, "You don't understand. It doesn't happen like this. You don't just get like a girl being like that."
And if you're 16, you don't get to call the shots. Unless you're Avril Lavigne.
Everyone thought that I was going to be like a Faith Hill, Shania Twain, and I'd be like, no, I want to rock.
You have a reputation for being in charge.
Well, I mean, it's my face that's out there, it's my name, it's my picture on the album cover. I need to make sure that represents me fully.
If you had completely had your way with how to market, how to position this young girl, what would we be seeing today?
I probably would have had her prettied up and, you know, maybe the clothes would have been a little tighter, a little more revealing, and a little more sparkles going on, a little more bling. I'm telling you, I would have messed it all up. Being normal is what's hot today, and the simple beat, the simple melody, the catchy hook line, everything is simple. Less is more.
To me, how like you're famous and then everybody goes all glamorous and all glory, and it's kind of like, it's strange to me. I mean, okay, maybe, yeah, you make a bunch of money and you can afford all that stuff, but it's not something that I can really do. I just like to dress down, just formal and comfortable, and that's my style. That's cool.
The Avril Lavigne look, tight tops, baggy pants, and wristbands, includes high top sneakers. And her fingers seem to have become entwined in her shoelaces.
Mess. I won't find it.
I just tried a ring.
I fiddle too much in interviews.
I don't know what you've done.
I don't know what I've done today.
Okay.
I'm trying to create a new style, right? Okay.
The music media have given a name to her style.
Oh, God, the anti-Britney. Look how pretty. Everybody just thinks because, you know, the whole pop thing, show off your belly, dance around with your background dancers, lip sync whole deal thing was really popular for a long time. I'm not made up, and I'm not being told what to say and how to act, so they have to call me the anti-Britney, which I'm not. I think that's very rude and very mean. I think it's a dumb game. It's just the media putting up fake those labels.
Well, it's not just the media.
Yeah.
It's a business. You're the product. In order to sell the product, you got to put some kind of label on it.
Yeah, see, that's what I don't like. I don't want to feel like a thing, and I don't want to feel like a product. And that's why that's what comes with pop music.
The industry does have a tendency to eat its young.
Right.
And in order to position the next big thing, someone has to pronounce the current big thing
over. Absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, that's an important marketing ploy. We're guilty of it, and it works. And it has worked quite well with Avril.
Total boyfriend.
Total boyfriend. No, I don't. Take me by the hand, take me somewhere new. I don't know who you are. That's the song called "I'm With You," and it was me having a depressing day and, you know, feeling those feelings.
That's where the good stuff comes from, musically.
Yeah,
they don't tend to come from great feelings, do they?
No. Every relationship I've been in has always, you know, ended up not on a great note. So, or maybe one day I'll be like, I'm in love and be able to write those sappy love songs.
Avril has plenty of dates ahead of her, concert dates. She's booked solid until the end of May. So how typical is this team, really?
Look, I think she has a typical way about herself, but I don't think she's typical at all. I listen to her songs, and I listen to the lyrics, and I read the lyrics, and I'm so, so impressed that someone could be so prolific and so special at such a young age. So you're right, she's anything but ordinary, she's anything but typical. She just looks like a typical teen.
Is it what you wanted?
Yes, it's what I wanted. What I wanted was to be able to have everybody in this world to know my music and have tons of fans, and that's really cool. But there's like, you know, the whole other side to it, like promotion and photo shoots and all the press. That part's kind of weird. But things don't overwhelm me, and that's why I can deal with it. That's why I can handle the whole thing, I guess. I think things will calm down now. You think so?
Not for a while.
Okay.
Next month, Avril may pick up her first Grammy, if not her first five. She's nominated for Song of the Year, Best New Artist, Best Female Pop Vocal Performance, Pop Vocal Album, and Best Female Rock Vocal Performance. Her second CD is due later this year, one she promises will rock even harder than the first.